So, let it never be said that Stefan Molyneux doesn't know his audience. So he posts this picture, and we all seen like liberals post this before. You know, the Sweden is closing their prisons due to the lack of people to put in them, but the United States prisons are 40% over capacity. It's just a land of the free. And of course, Stefan Molyneux, at his own caption, saying that Sweden banned hitting children in 1979, the first country to do so. The hen that smacks the cradle kills the world. And I love it when he tries to sound like so profound, like, oh, it's like poetry, but it's silly. And this is silly too. And if you don't know why, I'm gonna advise you to go either in under your sink or wherever, or in your laundry room, wherever you keep it, and find a thing called bleach. Sometimes it'll say like Clorox on it, and then you go get a shot glass and pour yourself a shot and take a shot for humanity. Stefan Molyneux is a philosopher. He should know what the correlation fallacy is. There's a lot of differences between the two different countries, and you can blame it on pretty much anything. Pick your pet issue, right? You want to ban guns. Well, guess what? Sweden has pretty strict gun control laws. Not the strictest, but they have pretty onerous regulations you got to jump through in order to get a gun, right? If you're a racist, you could say it's because, you know, there's white homogeneity in the population, right? So, you know, you don't have all these evil minority races, you know, who are the sole cause of society's ills, according to them. You could say that, you know, it's because they have this, you know, these subsistence programs that allow people to like not work and still have an apartment and a car and everything that they ever need. You could also say that. You could also say that they have a little bit more sensible policies when it comes to incarceration times. Like Andrew Brennick, the guy that like bombed the building in Oslo and shot a bunch of kids at a summer camp. What is he getting, like 20 years? America, we put him in jail for the rest of his life. Sweden has a little bit more laxed rules of when it comes to getting caught with drugs than the United States does, and many different states. I mean, just pick whatever you want, whatever your pet peeve is. And of course, Stefan Molyneux's pet peeve, his pet issue, is spanking. So of course, it's spanking that's the reason why. And then of course you have the elephant in the room. So you have an anti-statist happy about another country passing a prohibitionary law. Yeah, this isn't a cult.